There are some attributes of a PI tag that simply can't be changed. Those are system created. Things like the record of who created the tag, when it was created, when it was changed, who changed it, that type of thing. So those are things that you more or less you're stuck with those because they're system generated. And here is an example of those. We go over to our point builder in system management tools. I've selected a tag. If you go into system, this is going to show you those system attributes. These are things that we really can't change. Now, if for some reason you need to rename a tag, you can do that. That's not a problem. It'll preserve all the history, and it won't have any effect on things like processbook and data link, on PI processbook, because processbook makes reference to these tags with their internal ID. And maybe you didn't see this a little earlier, but if you look at this, this is the point ID. Each tag has a point ID. This is the tag sinusoid, and it's the first tag that's created in every PI system. As I said, it's one of those default PI tags. If you do create the default tags, then this is going to be your point number one. And that's, in fact, how we store the reference to that tag within processbook. However, datalink is an add-in to Excel, and we simply hard-code the name of the tag in datalink. So any type of data link reports, after you edit the name of a tag, you're going to have to change those data link reports. Also, if you've got any performance equations or performance equation expressions that are making use of PI tags, in other words, there is a PI tag name embedded in a performance equation expression, then that's going to continue to work up until the point when at which you you stop and restart performance equations. And so that's something obviously you need to edit that. So better to edit after making changes, anything that may be affected by that. Unfortunately, we don't really have any kind of a notification to let you know which tags are going to be affected by an edit to a name change or to a tag name. So that's something you're going to have to look for using tag searches and looking for the different attributes of your different performance equation tags or tags that use performance equation syntax. Now, same for deleting a tag. Deleting a tag is going to have some ramifications. First of all, it's going to delete all the archive data that's associated with that tag. Actually, we should be careful the way we say that. We don't delete the archive data. We just make it so that you can't get to it anymore, which is more or less the same thing. So although it is possible to recover that situation, be very careful about deleting a tag. It's kind of a nightmarish set of procedures that you'll have to step through with tech support to recover the data from a deleted PI tag. And as you'll see, there is no quick undelete to that. So because it is such a severe problem if you delete the wrong one, one of the things we suggest you do is just turn the scan attribute off and see if anybody complains that you're not looking at that data anymore, or you're not able to see that current data. That will still allow people to look at historical data. So also, we suggest you keep a copy of the configuration of all your tags, since things like the point ID, the record number, those things are going to be required if you do try to do a recovery. Now, what we've seen some sites do is they kind of collect up, store up tags for deletion, and then only delete them once per quarter or so. So they set things to scan off, just make sure nobody is actively using that data, and then when they're good and ready and they've proved to themselves they're not going to be shooting themselves in the foot, then they'll go ahead and delete the tags.